Dear students, welcome to the video lecture series of Digital Image Processing. This is the lecture number 10. In today's lecture, I shall be starting a new chapter, unit of Digital Image Transforms. Let us start today's lecture where you are going to study about the need for image transforms. In today's lecture, you will be studying about these topics named as need for image transforms, spatial frequencies in image processing, introduction to Fourier transform, discrete Fourier transform, and fast Fourier transform. Let us begin with the need for image transforms. What is the requirement of image transformation? From the term itself, you will be able to identify why. What is the requirement? Why to do this? You know that many image processing operations can be applied in both spatial domain and frequency domain, and many imaging operations can directly be performed in spatial domain because there is a manipulations of pixels only, and the advantage is they can be visualized very easily. But same types of operations can also be performed in frequency domain. If you talk about frequency domain, it deals with the frequency components of the image. You know that most of image processing applications are real-time applications. Certain examples are biometric applications like fingerprint-based attendance, airport baggage screening system, radar image monitoring. And all these real-time applications requirements are speed must be high and it should be as simple as possible. So depending upon the type of applications, there is a requirement of image transform. I've told you that image processing applications can be applied both in spatial domain and in frequency domain. Image transform means changing a problem representation which can help to solve the problem faster. Let us understand by taking an example. Here you can see that in this particular diagram, in case of figure A, see there are two forms being mentioned. In form 1, there is a multiplication of two numbers which have been represented in Roman form. So it would be quite difficult to multiply into the Roman. But if you convert this representation into the Arabic numerical system, means 12 into 10, directly you will be able to multiply. In second case, see if there is a form 1 which is of long integer form, means 12,000 needs to be multiplied with the 15,000. Here it is just an example, this number may be very, very long. But if you convert this form into the polynomial form where you are writing 12,000 as 12 into 10 raised to the power 3 and 15,000 and 15 into 10 raised to the power 3, its multiplication would be very easy, very simple. So here you can also see that this problem is being represented into this form to perform at a very fast rate, and this representation can be done into this manner so that problem can be simplified at a very fast rate. Spatial and frequency domains are different representations. One is in the time domain and other is in the frequency domain. Therefore, information needs to be converted from spatial to frequency, means time domain to frequency domain. Information conversion needs to be done. Mathematical transforms like Fourier transform, cosine transforms are helpful in these conversions. You have studied about the Fourier transform, Fourier properties, DFT, FFT in your previous semesters as well. So here just a review of all those topics as well. Image data which is into the spatial domain is being converted into the frequency components, means frequency domain, with the help of the mathematical transformations. While inverse transformation is also possible, means from frequency domain to the spatial domain. And this transformation is known as an inverse transformation. So transformation and then again applying inverse, you will be able to retrieve the original message or the image. In this diagram, general steps of operations is being shown. See, fxy is the input image which is in the spatial domain. Xy are the spatial coordinates, and if you talk about the image, f of xy is the intensity level at that particular coordinate. Pre-processing is being done. Then with the inverse discrete Fourier transform, you will be able to convert it into the frequency domain. And with the help of inverse transform, again, it will help you to gives you the reconstruction about the original image. See, here you have written fxy, here you have written gxy. Gxy is same as fxy because here at the output, our objective is to recover the original image, which should be same as the image which is being transmitted or the function which is being transmitted. But since it is the approximation, so you can write it as gxy or some other terms as well. Spatial frequencies in image processing, the next topic. You heard the term frequency very well. This term is used for the rate of repetition of signal in a spatial domain. You always talk about frequency is what? 1 upon time period. A spatial frequency is used to describe the rate of change of pixel intensity of an image in space. So this is what? The rate of change of pixel intensity. It can be visualized using the line profile of the image in any row or column, where x-axis denotes the distance of the pixels and y-axis represents the gray value. In case of 8-bit image, the gray value ranges from 0 to 255 because there are 256 gray levels are possible only. Means with the 8-bit image, 2 raised to the power 8 means 256 total levels are possible. You can see the image profile. How intensity profiles are very useful in image processing. You see this particular image, and with the help of this given image, intensity profile is being drawn. On x-axis, you have taken the distance, and on y-axis, gray levels have been represented, means intensity level. See, if you start from left to right, on the left, there is some darker portion, grayish. As well as you move from left to right, it varies to the brighter, means gray to white. So you can see gray level, and then when moving from gray to white, its value is increasing. Pixel value intensity level of y is white is highest one, and after reaching highest white, again it is increasing towards the gray and getting down to the black. See, white is the highest component, then again gray level is being increasing, so it is decreasing and reaching towards the black level, this one. And again from black to white, so this black to white, sorry, this is what white level, and this is what black level is being represented. So in this way, intensity profile of any image can be drawn and can be accessed. Intensity change can be expressed by this particular equation. You can see in the sinusoidal form, I is what? Sine of ux. X is the distance across the image, you can see on the x-axis, and u is the spatial frequency. In case of 8-bit gray level image, we have taken 8-bit in general because this is a commonly used gray level image. So the expression will be I is what? 127.5 into sine of 2 pi u x upon m plus this particular term. You know it. Here this term 2 pi is used to convert the spatial frequency from cycles to radian per image. Now, let us discuss about the types of image transforms. There are two possible types of image transforms, means broadly it is categorized into two categories. One is image transforms based on the orthogonal properties, other is on the non-sinusoidal. So orthogonal image transform is use basic functions which are sinusoidal in nature, like Fourier transform and discrete Fourier transform, DFT. Non-sinusoidal image transform use functions that are non-sinusoidal in nature, like Haar, Walsh, Hadamard, SVD, KL transforms. So in the coming lectures, you are going to study about both of these types of image transforms in detail. Some of the practical applications of the image transforms are: they convert spatial information to frequency domain information. Useful for getting information about sampling. They help to design faster algorithms. And spatial frequency transforms helps in assessing image quality. Most popular transforms are unitary transforms. If the transform result, two possibilities will be there. If matrix having only real numbers, then such type of matrix is known as a orthogonal matrix. If matrix is having complex numbers, it is known as Hermitian matrix. Basis for transform. What is the basis for image transform or transform from one form to the another? You know that an image is a 2D signal. Therefore, two-dimensional transforms are required to represent image in terms of discrete set of basic images. Means for two-dimensional image representation, there is a requirement to convert it from the spatial domain into the frequency domain. If you take an image of size n cross n, then you can see that forward and inverse transforms can be written as forward transform, means while converting from spatial to frequency domain. This is what, since images of size n cross n means n rows and n columns, x varies from 0 to n minus 1, y varies from 0 to n minus 1, t of y, u, v, x, y into original image. And the inverse transform, where we have to recover our original image from the image which is being transformed into the frequency domain. Variation of u and v, because we have taken a symmetrical image n cross n, n rows n matrix, I of x, y, u, v into g of u, v, means multiplication with the original image. This is how the forward and inverse transforms can be written in mathematical manner. Their terms T, I are known as forward and inverse transformation kernels. So this kernel is a very important term in the case of image transforms, and it is helpful while doing the transforms from one form to the other. Transformations have some important properties. Means kernels is known as separable. If mathematically it can be written into this form, T of this is what, T1 u of x into T1 of v of y. Means this is in the spatial domain x and this is in the frequency domain. Kernel is called symmetric if it is being written into this form, like T2 of u comma x and T2 of v comma y. So this kernel is having two basic important properties. One is separable and other is symmetric. and these properties are utilized in the image transform. Let us revise some of the concepts of the Fourier transform. Fourier transform is a unitary transform and it is based on the concept of vectors and basis images. Let us assume a continuous function fx. Here variable x represent distance. So the Fourier transform of continuous function, which is denoted by fu, here this u is the spatial frequency, can be written as integration minus infinity to infinity fx cos of this term minus j of sine. And it can be expressed in a concise manner while manipulating it into the exponential form and can be written as this: fx e raised to the power minus 2 pi ux into dx. So this is the way to write it into the concise manner. And inverse Fourier transform is expressed as, see, you are very well aware about this Fourier transform, inverse Fourier transform expressions. In exponential form, how to write it? Inverse Fourier transform in exponential form means in the concise manner can be represented in this form. Fourier transform can be extended to 2D functions as well. Like in the previous equation, it has been written for the one-dimensional function. There was one variable only. But it can be extended to 2D because most of the images have been represented into two-dimensional fxy. So Fourier transform for 2D image is given by, here the variation of both x and y varies from minus infinity to infinity and the same terms. And inverse transform, see, fxy is what? Same, f of u comma v e raised to the power 2 pi ux plus vy du into dy. So this is the way the Fourier transform is being extended into two-dimensional function. Now let us discuss about the DFT. DFT is discrete Fourier transform. Here images are digitized so that it is necessary to have discrete formulation of Fourier transform. Discrete Fourier transform for one-dimensional function can be represented as, means u is in the frequency domain, x varies from 0 to n minus 1, we have taken n samples, fx cos of 2 pi ux upon m minus j sine 2 pi ux upon m. And in its concise form, it can be represented into the exponential form, where again x varies from 0 to m minus 1, total m samples fx into this particular term. So this is the way to write the DFT for one dimensional function. Inverse DFT can also be written as, means inverse DFT while retrieving original information from the spatial domain, means conversion of spatial domain information from the frequency domain. See, fu can also be written as a product of ru plus j of iu, where ru is what? Real term, and iu is the imaginary term. So its magnitude can be written as what? Magnitude will be under root of r square u plus I square u. And this magnitude term gives us the Fourier spectrum. A spatial position information of image data is encoded as the difference between the coefficient between the real and imaginary data. You must be able to relate the term. The difference is known as a phase angle. And how to represent it? It is represented by 10 inverse imaginary term upon the real term. This DFT can also be extended from 1D to 2-dimensional function and 2-dimensional to understand the concept of the images. Here, if fxy is an array of m cross n, then 2-dimensional image can be represented as the Fourier transform and inverse Fourier transform. But here, for the simplicity, let us assume if m is equal to n, means it is a symmetrical array where number of columns and number of rows are same, then for this f of uv, again here because both the number of rows and columns are same, x varies from 0 to n minus 1, see, y varies from 0 to n minus 1, input image fxy e raised to the power minus j pi 2 pi ux plus vy upon n. While writing its inverse variation of u and v from 0 to n minus 1, and from this frequency domain function, a spatial domain conversion is being done. 2-dimensional DFT is having a property that it is separable, symmetric, and unitary. So these are the properties of 2-dimensional discrete Fourier transform. See, magnitude can be calculated as under root of r square uv plus I square, means the square of the real term plus square of imaginary term and its under root. And the phase angle is being calculated with the 10 inverse imaginary upon real term. Power spectrum can also be calculated as you have used to calculate in the communications. Power spectrum is what? Square of real term plus square of the imaginary term. DFT can be formulated as matrix operations. This is the beauty of the discrete Fourier transform, and it can be visualized as mapping from vector x to another vector y. So in the case of DFT, this mapping is being done so beautifully that it can gives you the enhanced result at a very fast rate. If you have to write it in matrix form, it can be visualized at y is what? W into t. W is known as a kernel, and Wn is the nth root of unity. If you need to write down the, you can write down the kernel for any value of m. Here, let us take an example where m is equal to 5. So how the kernel will be written as? See, for m is equal to 5, Wm means here it would be W5. The coefficients will be Wn first, the coefficients of first row W0, second row, these coefficients. So this is the way the kernel of can be written for m is equal to 5. DFT can be represented as y is what? Kernel of w into x. Now how to write the inverse transformation? Inverse will be what? Again to recover x from the y. So it would be w inverse into y, or 1 by n w its conjugate into x. Now let us talk about the fast Fourier transform. Till now, you have studied about the Fourier transform, discrete Fourier transform. So you got to know that the 2-dimensional discrete Fourier transform can be calculated by applying 1-dimensional DFT for each column of fxy and then performing 1-dimensional DFT for each row. Means application is being done from first for each column and then for the row in case of DFT. DFT algorithms are computationally intensive. So a faster version of algorithm is required, and the developed algorithm is known as FFT, which is known as Fast Fourier Transform. FFT uses a strategy known as successive doubling method. This is a very interesting strategy of FFT. You must have solved number of questions based on this technique. A fast Fourier transform is an algorithm that computes DFT of a sequence or its inverse IDFT. Means for the Fourier forward operation, DFT needs to be performed, and for the backward inverse IDFT. Fourier transform can be expressed as FU is what? For all values of M, it varies from 0 to M minus 1. If it starts from 1, you can write it up to M FX W of M. UX for when you have considered for the one dimensional. Here you know that Wm is what? E raised to the power minus j 2 pi upon m. But when you are writing for Wm, for all ux values, it would be e raised to the power minus j 2 pi ux upon m. Here it is assumed that the number of points m, this is equal to the power of 2. So m can be expressed as this particular equation, where k is a positive integer. Now, upon substituting this value in the equation of Fourier transform, you can get fu is what? 1 upon 2k. X varies from 0 to 2k minus 1 fx w of this. And if you expand it, then it would be a sum of these two terms. It can be shown that W of this term is equal to W of this, means 2k, 2uk, it can be approximated as k of ux. So by utilizing this term from this particular equation, we can write it as, see, first term is as it is, while second term is being written into this form. See, this particular term, W of 2k values, U of 2x plus 1, it would be Wk ux into W 2k of u. For f of even and odd values, the expressions will be the number of even terms 1 by k, x varies from 0 to k minus 1, f of 2x and this term. For odd numbers, it would be written into this form. I'm not going to explain you in detail about how to write it because you have done intensive exercise by writing to summarize all these equations into these forms. For u varies from 0 to k minus 1. Therefore, the equation is reduced to 1 upon 2 f of even plus f of odd into this particular term. Just you have simply manipulated all the terms. Due to the periodic properties, the rest of the spectrum is calculated by f of uk u plus k. This is equal to 1 upon 2 f even minus f odd into W term. FFT algorithm is based on the principle of divide and conquer method. This method is very interesting. Means the whole method is being divided into two parts. In this principle, if the problem is big, it is first divided into sub problems. So this process is known as divide. After dividing, these problems are solved and individual solutions are combined to get final solution, which is known as conquer. So the whole process is being divided into two parts, divide and conquer. Here, a FFT decomposition have been shown. See, one signal of 16 points have been taken, 0 to 15. Then in the next stage, it has been divided into two signals of 8 points. One signal of 8 point and this is the another signal of 8 point. See, 0 to all even numbers have been taken over here, alternative you can say, and the rest one have been taken into here. So here two signals of 8 points. In the next stage, it can be further subdivided, four signals of 4 points. See, 0, 4, 8, 12, and the remaining numbers are over here. Here 1, 5, 9 and 13. In the next stage, again it can be further subdivided. There is a scope, means 8 signals of 2 points. 8 signals means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And each and every signal is having 2 points. Further, it can be divided into 2 halves. So 16 signals of 1 point means we have started from 1 signal, goes up to 16 signals. Started with 16 point, goes up to 1 point, where each and every point is solved separately, and after that the solution of all these 16 signals have been combined, which is known as the process of Conquer. So this FFT decomposition process is very interesting. So students, in today's lecture you have studied about the need of image transform, why there is a requirement to transform the image from one form to the another form, spatial frequencies in image processing, how to represent it, types of image transforms, there were two types, orthogonal and non-sinusoidal types, basis for transforms, you have studied what are the basic fundamentals, then introduction to Fourier transforms, means how to represent the forward signal and the inverse for one-dimensional and two-dimensional. Then we have discussed about the discrete Fourier transform, that is DFT, and after that FFT. In case of DFT, you have studied how to represent the forward and inverse for the one-dimensional and two-dimensional signals, and for the FFT also we have discussed about the algorithm which is known as divide and conquer. So how this problem can be solved by using fast Fourier transform. Thank you all. Keep watching the next video lecture where we will be studying about the properties of Fourier transform, discrete cosine transform and discrete sine transform. Thank you.